We have over 40 years worth of engineering experience in the Australian landscape. Hi, I'm Trevor Burrellan from Walkinshaw Automotive Group. Been working on this project for the last couple of years, the Isuzu D-Max Blade. The brief that Isuzu gave Walkinshaw was to improve on the ride and handling without compromising the towing or payload capabilities of the vehicle. Through our validation phase, we covered over 100,000 kilometres worth of local road conditions. Isuzu approached Walkinshaw to develop the suspension for the Isuzu D-Max Blade, capitalising on over 40 years worth of experience developing suspension systems for road cars in Australia. So for this project, we selected a 35mm twin tube damper, and that's an upspec from the 30mm original equipment that's fitted to the car. A twin tube damper offers us the advantage that it carries more fluid, and with more fluid, you get much better temperature control. So the durability is bolstered because the outer chamber, the outer case of the damper, is not the chamber in which the piston is traveling. So if you do get a dent or a little bit of damage out in the bush, you're not impeding your piston, as opposed to a single tube. If you do damage it, then you lose damper performance almost immediately. Also has the benefit of having a piston shaft that is almost twice the diameter of the OEM equipment. That offers the benefit of having lateral stability and more consistent performance through the damping motion. So we went through 16 iterations on the rear and 14 iterations on the front. Basically what happens is that we try to get the best out of our valving. When we go and assess each of the valve changes, we'll have a bunch of positives and negatives. We'll try to tune the negatives out and maintain the positives as we go through the development process. We've also increased the ride height of the vehicle. It's increased by 22.5 mil in the front, just on the suspension, and by 25 mil on the rear. The added ride height in the rear improved articulation and packaging space for the larger wheel and tyre without compromising payload or towing capability. The track is increased by 18 mil per side by increasing the offset of the wheel. Increasing the track gives you a much better steering feel, but also ride and handling is improved. So we've got a really good trusted history with Munro. Munro have also got a lot of experience in Australia. They've been developing suspension systems for the Australian environment for many, many years. So that made Munro a logical choice for us to partner with to develop such a special suspension system for this vehicle, the Blade. So we did look at other springs for this program. We assessed them and found that we were able to do the job with the standard springs that came with the vehicle, both front and rear, and work with those spring rates and adjust the damper tuning to suit those without compromising any of the payload or towing capability. So we have an engineering team of approximately 60 people split across multiple disciplines. So we have mechatronics engineers, electrical engineers, mechanical, software, and they cover all areas of the vehicle.
My name is Henry Wright, and I'm the manager for Powertrain and Validation. Behind me is the four-post suspension rig. We have 4,000 PSI of hydraulic pressure connected to four actuators. So one of the great things about this suspension rig is it allows us to go out into the real world, collect that road data, bring that road data back into the lab, and repeatedly play it into the vehicle. It's very, very consistent, so what we can do is we can make small changes to the damper valving and evaluate the effect between each change on the same piece of road. Some of the tests we're able to play into the vehicle are a torsional warp, a pothole strike test, and a road replay of a rough track. One of the other things we've done with the rig is measure the chassis torsional rigidity and use that information to help design the features at the front of the vehicle we put on, such as the bash plate and the tow hooks.
So what we did, and this is a first as far as I'm concerned, is to connect the two tow hooks via a cross brace system so that when you apply a load to one tow hook, you're applying it to the entire frontal area of the vehicle, right? So you're not at risk of damaging one or the other chassis rail. To validate that that was all okay, we ended up doing rig testing in three directions, right? So dead on, then 35 degrees outboard and 35 degrees inboard. We applied an 8-ton load in all three directions and found that there was minimal movement through the chassis. So it was a really good distribution of loads right through the frontal system of the car. Due to its nature, underbody protection has to offer extreme levels of strength, but also corrosion resistance due to the volatile environment that it's in. To achieve this, we added a level of E-coat, which is capable of withstanding 480 hours of salt spray abuse, and also 80 microns of powder coat, which just bolsters that corrosion resistance for the product. So the engineering brief was to improve the off-road capability of this vehicle. For off-road capability, you're required to have much more sidewall on the tyre. So to do that, we had to reduce the size of the rim. We went from an 18-inch rim to a 17-inch rim. And to seat the tyre with a better, stronger seat, we went for a wider tyre and a wider rim. So we went from a 7.5-inch rim to an 8.5-inch rim. So for the blade, we decided to go with a cast flow form process for the wheels. So cast flow form offers three key attributes. So there's bang for buck, there's durability, and there's design freedom. For this program, we've selected a Goodyear DuraTrack all-terrain tyre. The tyre was selected because of its performance off-road, and we did some development work with Goodyear specifically for this program. The tyres were selected for their great off-road capability, but also for the low road noise that they produce. These tyres also have a triple ply in the sidewalls that offer increased puncture resistance, which is obviously a big benefit out in the bush. So for towing validation, we tend to run a vehicle with and without towing. We'll run those vehicles together through all conditions. So there'll be weather testing along outback highways, there'll be hill climbs up around the Flinders Ranges, and we'll just monitor the temperatures. But from a temperature perspective, what's really important is that when we're designing things like grills and fascia inserts, that we don't impede the airflow any more than the original vehicle.
My name's Julian Quincy. I'm Chief Designer here at Walkinshaw Group. Isuzu, we're very focused on delivering a unique vehicle, a unique off-road focused vehicle for the Australian market. To get to this stage today, we've built over a dozen prototypes. Our core vehicle is the LSU Plus. Normally that wouldn't be available in the grey and the orange hero colours, but we've managed to obtain those, which means that on our top of the range, strongly off-road focused Blade Hero product, we're able to offer two of our strongest hero colours. We worked very hard with Isuzu in supplying a core vehicle that minimises waste, mitigates any kind of wastage, so we can reduce our green footprint. The vehicle comes with the right door handles, mirror scalps, comes with steel wheels, comes without side steps. What that means is we're not removing perfectly good components and throwing them straight in the bin. Minimises any kind of green footprint, and it means we get a sharp price point on the vehicle as well, so everyone's a winner. We actually saw the very first pilot cars that were built, and we were seeing and scanning that car 6 months before the guys here in Australia were able to see their very first new generation D-Max. So we're pretty privileged to get that early start on the program, and it allowed us to start developing the core components on the front end of the vehicle in particular. Make sure that it would all fit and the quality of the interfaces would be second to none. We did some detailed scans, both the whole body side, the top, the bonnet, the whole front end, and then we'd remove the bumper, scan what's behind there, because we've got to decide if we're using the same clipping method or whether we're using the same shrouding behind the radiator. And essentially, this becomes our Bible for then developing our new surfaces. So any component that's going to fit onto the Isuzu components, we've got to know where those Isuzu components are and whether there's any clashes with any components behind the A surface. So that trip became the set in stone master data that we then use to develop all these items in-house. It's always exciting seeing the first time you see a vehicle in three dimensions. We had some 3D printed grills, 3D printed wheel arch flares, and we started assembling our very first pilot vehicle in this actual studio. And It was fantastic. The fit and finish of this in particular, the grille onto the front bumper following CAD that's developed against a scan of a vehicle. We were very, very happy with the fact that the quality is just fantastic. In terms of the design influence, we try to take the Isuzu D-Max design theme with its chiseled, confident design language and amp it up to factory 11. Fundamentally, it's totally integrated with the vehicle that's already there, builds upon its core strength. So makes a great statement, but again, looks equally part of the Isuzu range. The wheel is one of the earliest parts of this vehicle we worked on. The wheel is an inch wider. It's got a great offset and it's also a wider tire. So what that's done is it's brought the outside edge of the tires out by 23 millimeters per side, and it gives this incredibly strong, aggressive stance to the vehicle. It's a split six-spoke design. It's got a really deep dish, which gives it a really tough off-road look. It's actually a 17-inch wheel because we wanted to increase the depth of the sidewall of the tire to absorb some of those off-road shocks you get when you're doing real off-roading. We've actually featured the semi-hex graphic within the design of the wheel. It's one of those early parts that really gelled immediately we started working on it. And that was one of the design items we then went on to incorporate into other areas of the vehicle design. One of the other main ticket items is the front grille, which is quite a massive change for us. It's quite a compliment to be given the opportunity to play with someone's brand identity to this extent. So we've set the Isuzu fangs wide apart at the top of the grille there. We've got a strong three-dimensional piece of branding with the Isuzu lettering really brought out. The Isuzu design language features heavily this hexapod feature, which is a six-sided shape. And quite unbeknown to us, we've actually picked up on half of that in a lot of this vehicle and featured what I would call a semi-hexagon shape. So you see that repeated on these bridges underneath the teeth there. You see it repeated in the design of the grille mesh. On the grille, we feature this integrated light bar, but you'll see the bridge there is very strongly this semi-hex graphic, which integrates incredibly well into the front end of the vehicle. The other major changes at the front are the lower applique, where we've got these tough override features. Again, six-sided, plays well into the hexapod design language, and that integrates with the bash plate and tow hook. In terms of finishes, the blade features a really strong suite of black accenting. We use the very strong design of the decals to give this a very obvious down the road graphic, where you can pick it out as being something quite unique within the range. The upper grille is matte black. Then we have self-molded black, and we tie that in with the red Isuzu branded bash plate and tow hooks at the front end there. The vehicle's got this really nice crisp raising line along the side of the vehicle, and at the back again it uses this semi-hexagon shape at the rear. So what we've chosen to do with the decals is really accentuate the sculpting that's already there, making sure that people can see this lovely sculpture that Isuzu designers have got into the core vehicle, and kind of bringing them out so everyone can see the sculpture that's already there. Gone for a lift on the vehicle. This gives us additional presence, just pure down the road strength and that grunt factor. But also, of course, it's giving you additional ground clearance, so really useful off-road. We've got a unique sports bar that we've designed and engineered. This gives us a very sporty silhouette and ties back nicely into the angle of the rear tail lamps. Side steps, we've got the same finish as the sports bar, so those two items tie in really well together. And with the design of the side step molding, we've actually repeated the design of the front grille mesh. So there's a nice subtle interplay between those two design identities, where you'll see the same pattern feature on both items. So we've got these wide wheel arch flares. They're designed with the semi-hex design. That visually eats up a lot of the height of the vehicle and also avoids the need to feature a cutout for the fuel filler cap. So a nicely integrated solution that works well with the other design language of the vehicle. This program's been a lot of fun, and I feel that our partnership with Isuzu has been very interesting, because I think they've become enthused about the possibilities of delivering some really strong identity. And We've been enthused by just how on board they've been about delivering a unique identity. They've upped the ante in terms of some of the componentry. They've given us the opportunity to work on quite a uniquely different front grille, which is very unusual, and we feel it's made a huge difference in terms of the down the road graphic of this vehicle. I think it's going to stand out within the greater Ute market, but any Isuzu dealership, you're going to be able to pick this car out from a mile away.